started as a clerk, inventory clerk with AT&T, Plaza Baldwin Pacific. I became the team leader of that group. Mm-hmm. Now, after 3 months, I was... yan. Teka, teka, boy!
Ano pa, ano pa?
Ilabas mo siya para hindi maingay. Apa,
pinaka.
Repeat, refrain. O, sige.
Can you tell us the first background and how you started your career as an accountant?
After pass, I took the CP exam and then I was hired in 1973 as an actual employee of Atlantic Baltimore Pacific as an inventory clerk. I became the team leader of that group. And then, after 3 months, the treasurer of the company picked me up to handle the work at the treasurer's office as a junior accountant. I was the first woman to handle it and non-CPA. Mm-hmm. And because it's really hard, it was not easy because I have to stay up to 10 o'clock in the evening just to do the job. And then so when I passed the CPA exam at the same year, the treasurer was very, very happy and treated me at the Manila Polo Club. It's my first time to go there. And then when it's a very expensive club pala siya. Yeah, that's, I started that way. And then after that, I worked with the agency for 2.5 because I worked Monday to Sunday. Monday to Sunday. After 2.5 years, I resigned. And my boss said, "Why did you resign?" "Sir, wala akong buhay." So, and then I was tapped to work for another company, yun nga, as head of the accounting unit of Masaganda Sahan. We were the first to handle the, we were the pioneer employee of that company. So we started from zero, hanggang sa more than 100 employees. And I have about 50 staff under me dun sa MSI. Because I handle different departments, general accounting, project accounting, taxation, budgeting, MIS, ako din yung gumagawa ng mga SOPs. Kaya when I work dun sa, when I resigned from my work because of my rheumatoid arthritis, I started with a, I thought it's the end of my career when I resigned as a chief accountant. And my friend said that sayang daw ako. So they gave me some, it was actually my first client was Philippine Bible Society. I did some management audit there, and I got 6 people. So we worked on the management audit, and then later I got a psychometrician because we give exams, psychological exams to all the staff and to all the managers, so that you know whether that person is capable of handling the position, and then we come up with the about the HR, yung mga position ano tawag doon, function, yung mga responsibilities, we establish it, and then we try to find out what are the additional seminars that they need to or whatever to upgrade them so that they will be capable of handling the position, and then we come up with the MIS, yung kanilang simplification of their forms, mga ganon, and then 600 pages yung ginawa kong what you call this, yung mga SOPs for all the department, kaya 2 years ago yun, talagang nilinis ko yung because I'm used to it dahil dun sa aking position sa MSI. And then I became most of my companies I work with, they're paying the right taxes, hindi yung wala akong ganito, pwede. Talaga, everything was transparent.
What do you love the most about being
a what kind of love? Helping others, because when you're in this kind of career, you must love your work and you must love the sympathy, the empathy, to help them so that they will understand. There are times when I have a client now, they don't know anything about accounting, and they will tell me, can you give me the definition of terms so that I will understand? Can you please teach me? Mm-hmm. So that there are times I have to teach them. So I hope magkatapos sasabihin nila, madali lang pala, it's easy. I know that. May sasabihin nila, paano mag-board meeting? So i-explain mo sa kanila how to handle a board meeting, and then, madali lang pala. Okay. Others talaga. Siguro kasi meron ako empathy. Tsaka yung patience.
You've mentioned to kanina na you have handled different departments.
Yeah.
What have you learned from handling these departments? How did this help you grow professionally, socially,
Kasi actually, ang malaking factor doon, when I was handling this position, I was taking my master's degree at the Ateneo. Mm-hmm. So yung academics ko, I can easily relate, I can easily transfer. Kumbaga, parang ito yung theory, tapos ito yung practice. Para madali mo siyang Kaya sabi ko, if I'm just a mere accounting major, and I don't have this kind of masteral academics, it will not be that easy. So it helped me a lot. It broadened my horizon. And it's just a good thing na hindi ako rin mainis. At saka, there are times na, even though yung stress na ako, I try to laugh. Kasi, pag ikaw nagpa-stress at hindi ka tatawa, naku po, madami kang wrinkles. Yun.
What do you consider as your biggest accomplishment?
Of course, my biggest accomplishment is being a mother, mm-hmm. being an accomplished parent. Because as far as I'm concerned, I think when you are gone, my children will be able to stand on their own two feet because they are academically good, they have good positions. So my daughter has a PhD now, and my son has a master's degree in sports science in USA. Mm-hmm. Yeah, both of them had postgraduates in other countries. Na hindi naman kami mayaman, pero my children were good enough to be taught this. They really love to work, to study, and that's one thing very good.
Pero ma'am, in terms of your career, ano po yung consider niyo as your biggest accomplishment so far?
My biggest accomplishment is at least I never thought that I'll be able to handle so many clients all at the same time, and to be able to help them on their books, not cooking the books. I never do that. And then I think I am financially okay. Mm-hmm. I am financially okay. So I think it helped us with all this. The most new accomplishments is talagang helping them. Because if they have a problem, they keep on calling you. Ito ang unang tinatawag nila pag may problema, whatever. But I know that kaya ako hindi ako masalimin sa mga BIR. Kasi I don't, modesty aside, most of my clients, konti lang ang may LOA. Mm-hmm. Hindi pareho ng ibang clients na every year may LOA. Pag the first time na nagkaroon ako ng client, I was not the one who is the first their auditor before. Yun, may mga LOA sila. But once na hinawakan ko na sila, in due time, wala na LOA nila. Kasi they know, yung mga babalik-balik sa BIR, they know that we will not pay a single centavo to them. Kaya ang tingin ko, my accomplishment is being a real person. Yung talagang hindi ka God-fearing. Yung talagang I was able to do it that way. But, and God provides. Pag sinasabi ko, kung wala akong pera, whatever, hindi kami nag-aaway mag-asawa. Huwag ko dadating din niya.
Regarding sa paying the right taxes, what do you think it means when people, when they say that the taxes are the lifeblood of the government?
Oh yeah, kasi when you say the lifeblood, it's really how can a government function without funds? Because if they have labor, they need to pay it, materials, whatever, they need to, kaya it's the lifeblood. Kung wala, how can the government function? Even us, if we don't have money, how can we buy our food, buy our clothes, our everything? So we need funds, but money is not everything. It's just a means. Yeah, and you must. I was taught to, what do you call this? I was taught to earn and spend money. Yung bang hindi kasi my grandparents, my mother, all of them are too thrifty. Talagang masyado silang ano. But my auntie, when I went to London, I cannot buy this, I cannot buy this, it's so expensive. Sabi niya, you must learn how to spend. My auntie told me that. So, dati-dati computer ako ng computer. Like ano, calculator. But after a while, when I went abroad or went to another place, I will make a budget. Sometimes ago, we should have done a budget. So, I mean, that's it.
Mm-hmm. Being an accountant, po, do you agree that you are the moderators between the government and the taxpayers?
Oh, yeah, yes. Because you are in between. So, if you're not doing the right one, you're not a good moderator. Mm-hmm. So, diba?
Mm-hmm. Have you worked with companies or clients that ask you not to pay the right taxes?
Never. I have a good, because from the start, especially my clients, I'm telling them, if you have double books, I cannot accept you, because I don't accept clients with double books, because I want to sleep soundly.
So all of your clients, they are all advocates.
Yes.
What do you think are the top three possible reasons why business owners do not pay the right taxes?
Well, first, sometimes, because it's their first time in business, they don't know anything about taxes, they don't know anything about accounting. All they do is how to produce the product, how to sell the product, and after a while, they will say, I need to work on my accounting. That's the time that I need to pay my taxes, and I'm okay now. That's the time they will work. And second, there are times na, what you call this, they don't have money, because they don't have too much money for the day-to-day operations. But I don't think they really don't want to pay. I think, technically, they do not know about taxes.
I'm saying it's good to have
Yeah, to tell them, to advise them.
Something is not hard to do.
Sa taxes, gamitin ko muna sa production. Then something like that. Yeah. Kasi minsan may mga nung nagsisimula ako, may makikita ko mga clients na 5 years na nag-ooperate, hindi nagbabayad ng taxes. Sabi na, ba't hindi ko nagbabayad ng taxes? Kasi hindi ko alam yun eh. Kasi wala akong accountant eh. Kasi can you please help me? Ako hindi ako nagbo-bookkeeping eh. I will refer you to another person. This person will do all the proper bookkeeping. And then, after that, ako yung mag-audit. Kaya meron akong ka-counterpart na bookkeeping na kasama ko sa tax affairs. 10 or 15 clients, I give those money. Kasi ang daming tumatawag sa akin. So, I'm not doing any bookkeeping. Ang bibigay ko sa kanya, sa akin yung bibigay ang audit.
Does the BIR find out po na, like, in companies, like, that company?
Hindi. Because hindi siya registered eh. Wala siyang registration. Parang simula agad. Parang bang, pag may pera na sila, na meron na silang pambayad, that's the time na sila mag-register. Di ba maraming ganyan na entrepreneur? Madaming ganyan. Mga self-employed. Hindi sa mga professionals, hindi kasi may PTI. But yung mga nakilala ko na professionals, they really pay their taxes. Automatic kasi takot eh. Kasi professional eh. Pero yung mga self-employed, mga didiit, hindi. Because hindi sila registered.
Some clients ask their accountants to reduce their taxes. We have heard cases of tax evasion from celebrities, business owners, and individual professionals. What do you think are the challenges encountered by accountants and taxpayers in paying their right taxes?
Challenges. Well, probably that's the way of life. Parang they used to doing that thing, kaya kaya nila. Pero kung if their conscience is clear and they know what is proper, I don't think they will do it. That's nasa tao kasi.
We heard po some accountants saying na minsan hindi daw po maiiwasan.
So far sa akin, hindi applicable because I don't accept clients with double books.
So from the start pa na before you accept, naka-lay down na yung cards.
Yes, nililay down yung cards mo na. Kaya sabi, sorry. At alam nila, there are times na may mga clients ako na dahil ayaw nila magbayad ng right taxes, kinukuha ka na lang for internal. Just they would like to find out how much is my total assets, how much is my loan. Yung parang for them to understand, pero to sign their books, no. I will never sign anything. Kasi I want to sleep soundly. Nakandit lang yung professional fee. Tapos hindi ka makatulog. Excuse me. Modesty aside, maswerte ako na hindi kami ganun kahirap. Diba? Kasi kung mahirap na mahirap ka na, wala, you will be tempted. So far naman kasi, modesty aside, hindi naman kami ganun. Kaya, we were able to and we were reared properly. So, kaya hindi kami nagpagamit. At saka, si Dato, may kapatid ang buong. May kapatid yung dati yung sister, si Pinali dito, madre yan. So, my husband, yung eldest nila, single, yung namatay. Nasa Saudi yung mga full time. Tapos yung susunod yung madre, susunod yung medical doctor, kaklase na si Senator, ano bang Senator ito? Papatawa sa DOH.
Pag-layer.
Tapos, si Dado ang buhay. Si Dado lang nag-isama. So, Dado got his house. So, our all is coming from USP. So, kumbaga, may conscience kami. So, from the start, I said, no, I cannot accept that. Even when I was in MSI, I was so strict. Talagang very strict ako. Because I will say, pumasa ba kay Medi? Pag pumasa kay Medi, pwede na sa amin, kahit ma-open. Ganun ako kagrabi sa kuwa dati. Once I signed everything, accepted. Ganun ako kagrabi. Even my our president, si Tabaldon, they own almost everything in Nueva Ecija. Ang sabi niya, Lely, may meeting ako. Sir, hindi ko pa na-prepare ang mga cheque. Sabi niya, can I sign the checks? Be sure it's okay. Yes, sir. How many checks do you need? Sir, 20. People mind me. Lato. Tapos sabi niya, sir, anyway, si Mr. Labin will sign. Bankers. So, okay naman. So, kasi talagang everything, you do these things honestly.
So, what do you think are the three most important qualities or characteristics that an accountant should have? What do you think the government should do to help accountants become advocates of rights?